John Hawaii might have lost that point there, but Ahuna is once again becoming the fiery leader that this team needs right now. She comes up with the great digs time and again. She may again be the difference tonight in the match.
T. Williams off the block, hits two blockers twice, and they can't do much with it. And Williams gets the side out back for Hawaii. Hawaii leading 9-6. They won the first game 15-10. Back to serve Elinecki, set up in front by Stanford. Smith, Elinecki. T. Williams puts it in the opening. Chris, Stanford is not getting their sets real close to the net, and I think Smith's having some trouble getting it down. She keeps hitting it off the blocker, and Hawaii digs them.
And the reason for that is the passes are further off the net. There's T. Williams on the cutback shot right there. Hits the corner, nobody home. There's Rush with a great dump.
And Suzanne Egge with a great dive, and Jesse hits it long. It's 6-10. Wendy Rush back to serve. Stanford needs a rush right now. Good hard serve by Wendy. And a Jesse off the blocker. Kept alive. Reno can't do anything. What a frustrating position. The dig by Reno, and she watched helplessly as the ball dropped in front of her. Side out again to Hawaii.
Stanford, one of the fine defensive teams in the country. They don't let many balls that are in the air that long drop to the floor. Very unusual. They're a great defensive team.
Stanford number 3 in the country, Hawaii number 1. Ball lands in on the slam by Olsen. And back to serve, number 18, Teresa Smith. And that'll bring Jenny Chafee back into the game for Amy Hayes up front. Jenny Chafee 6'2", Hayes 5'10". A little more height up front now. It's a substitution we've seen before tonight. Watch the jump by Smith, and she hits the top of the net. Again, we seem to see it all year long, Chris, when there's a little pause in the momentum there, a little pause in the action, whether they're wiping up the floor or making a substitution. A lot of service errors come right after that.
Not only that, but Teresa Smith has already hit a lot of balls tonight, and she may be just a little bit tired to hit that jump serve.
And a good dink that time by Chafee.
Chafee is picking up right where she left off on Thursday night against Texas. She came in and had career-high kills. She's doing it again tonight.
6-10, here's Olsen back to serve for Stanford. Puts it deep in the middle, and too deep. And another service error for Stanford.
Stanford's seventh serve out. Hawaii only has 2 serves out for the match.
This is 6 years in a row now. Stanford has been to the Final 4. In 84, they lost to UCLA in the finals 3-2 after being ahead 12-4 in the 5th game. That's when these girls were freshmen. 85, they lost to Pacific 3-1. Last year, they were bumped out by Nebraska 3-1 after winning the first game. Very enigmatic team, Chris. Good enough to be here year after year. They have never brought it home. 7-10, though. Asper serving for Stanford. Elinecki. Chance for Stanford. Asper. Chafee. Ball is hit long. Coming back into the game now, Jamie Payette for Suzanne Egge. Payette will come in to serve and play some back row, some defense, and some digs. Payette puts it deep in the middle, set up front by Smith. Tough set though, Chafee couldn't do much with it. Chance now, Elinecki just punched it over, and here's a chance. Reno, miss hit, and T. Williams that time was beaten out for that ball. One of the rare times you'll see that. Two players going up at the net.
And look who was with her. Wendy Rush was the blocker that time. She's not only a great setter, but she has an excellent front court game. She's there, as I said earlier, her second best blocker percentage-wise.
7-10, Chafee serves, and T. Williams says, try stopping that one.
You might get T once, but you'll rarely get her twice.
And certainly not in a row. 10-7. All set up. Again, far from the net, and Smith off the blocker. Since her over runs over, almost runs over one of the floor wipers. Can't get to it. Side out, back to serve, way back to serve. Nancy Reno.
Cindy Lewis and Ann Miller that time made a great play. They're over there with the UHS ID, Tracy O'Reilly.
Our writers from the Star Bulletin and Advertiser. Up front, set up for Stanford, but again, net violation that time on Hawaii. It's 8-10.
T. Williams that time a little over anxious, wanting to get the stuff blocked that time after she got dug. She needs to just go on to the next play and not worry about being dug.
Stanford seems, Chris, to be just a hair off on their sets. They just have not been putting them away like that. There it is once again.
The T factor is now coming into play. That shot right there was world class.
Well, and as we see, Sincerova makes everybody look good with her sets on this team. All year long, her whole career, she's been doing it. Good diving save by Payette. T Williams puts it through Stanford. It's 11-8.
Great dig that time by Jamie Payette, playing for Suzanne Egge in the back row, and there's the girl who at the end of the play, Williams, already in the Long Beach Hall of Fame for her efforts during high school.
Ball dinked and Payette can't get there. Chris, two reasons why Stanford needs to put it away. Obviously to get some points and some side outs, but also because every time Hawaii, a good defensive team, pops that ball back up, there's a chance Sincerova's gonna get one of her great sets, and Hawaii's just got too many guns with Egge, Williams, and Jesse up front, and of course Ahuna and Elinecki. And there's Jesse. Great save, though, in the back by Chafee. And T. Williams with the roof.
One thing about T. Williams, if you go one-on-one with her and all she has to do is just stand there and go straight up, she'll win that battle almost every time. She really extends over the net. Watch the dug ball up here. The ball's bumped up. It'll be set fairly close. T. Williams reaches over and just roofs it straight down. There's the excitement.
T. Williams.
She is exciting.
Constructing a roof. She in the construction and the destruction business. Diana Jesse, great diving save by Reno, but it goes up into the crowd.
Hawaii just too much firepower right now, John. They've got too many heavy, heavy hitters, and even this great Stanford defense is having all kinds of trouble digging them.
And with that, Coach Don Shaw asked for a timeout with Hawaii leading game number two, 12-8. Back to live action is 12-8. Hawaii just serving, and here's Asper with a slam, and she puts it off the blocker. Hits Sincerova. It'll be side out to Stanford.
Smart hit that time by Laura Asper from Newport Beach, California, using Martina's hands that time to get the side out.
And Teresa Smith not using her jump serve. But a point for Stanford on the block up front. Asper and Olison doing the job that time, the underclassmen. Well, you see a shot of Olison, and there's Teresa Smith. Let's see if she does the jump serve. No. Just inside, and a chance now for Olison off of the Sincerova in the block. It's now 10-12, and Coach Dave Shoji says, I've seen enough, and he takes his timeout, and we'll be back with more action after this. Stanford serving, Jesse on the slam, kept alive by Stanford. It's 10-12, Chafee off the pole, it'll be side out to the Rainbow Wahines and Sincerova. Again, Hawaii, as they've done so effectively all season long, calling timeout and getting the ball back. 12-10, game number two. Line drive served by Sincerova, and a mistake on the set. Reno, I think, thought of letting that one go, Chris. Looked like it might be long, but when she said it, it went over, and Jesse pounds it away.
Again, this is Stanford's weakest rotation against Hawaii's best server, Martina Sincerova.
13-10, Reno again has to hit it over, and Egge, but a good block that time by Stanford. Teresa Smith, and again, Chafee hits it into the net. It's 14-10, Hawaii 1 point away from stretching their lead to 2 games to none. Sincerova, she'll be back next year for Hawaii. The serve. Reno diving all over the floor is Stanford, and Egge puts it away. It's 15-10. 15-10. Hawaii is one game away from a national title here in Indianapolis. Back ready for game number three. There you see Coach Shoji on the right and Melody Toth back in her home state of Indiana, and there is Dee Nowak, blonde hair behind.
Dave, there's Kepa Cummings, the trainer behind him. Here we have game three.
Stanford serving, T. Williams, whoopsie-daisy, she gets it over, chance for Stanford to pull ahead. Teresa Smith, ball does not go over the net, 4 hits on the Stanford side, and it's over to Hawaii. Chris, what's going through Stanford's minds right now? Here they are again in the final four, again they're down to what could be their last game.
Not a good sign when Teresa Smith, one of their top hitters, hits that ball into the net to start the game off.
And of course, as we say that, she slams one through the blockers. It'll be side out for Stanford. Smith is back to serve for Stanford. Jump serve by Smith. Sincerova, short set to T. Good dive there by Hayes. Blocked up front, Olsen. Jesse. Tita from behind the 10-foot line. Can't get it over.
John, one of the things that Coach Don Shaw has done is change his lineup slightly, rotated the girls around a couple of rotations, so they'll match up differently against Hawaii. He's trying anything he can now to get the girls fired up and hope to trick Hawaii a little bit by moving the rotation around. And what that does is it causes the Hawaii blockers to think about different things when they're up front. Different people have now got to be concerned about Wendy Rush. And now Mahina Alanecki is serving into Stanford's weakest rotation instead of Martina Sincerova.
He's also getting that weak rotation out of the way early in this game. Hopefully he hopes he can get through that and get his powerful spikers up front again.
That's right, but there's the T factor right there once again. She gets Hawaii's first point on the board. Excellent serve by Alanecki that time as well.
1-1, Mahina the Magician serves in the back. Smith up front. Rush up front off the net. Good diving play. Williams keeps it alive, sets it up to Bob Clark. But he's not playing for Hawaii. It'll be side out. Great reflexes by a referee there. Asker. Brother Olsen serving. Egg hits it deep. There's Olsen up front. Ball dinked over. Sincerova, great reflexes. Zelenecki keeps it alive. Like ping pong sometimes, but it's effective. Eggy with the dig. Zelenecki. Jesse hits it long. 2-1, Stanford goes ahead. Hawaii has not lost a game. They've beaten Arizona, Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo, Pacific, and Illinois 3-0, 3-0, 3-0, 3-0. Basically, that's unheard of coming through a championship. Ball lands out. Stanford pulls ahead 3-1.
John, this Hawaii cannot allow Stanford to get back into this match. They are too good a team, Stanford is. And if Hawaii looks back at all, or if they become less aggressive, or they let down, they're going to be in trouble because this is a very good Stanford team.
There was a great acrobatic move and a save that time. Only three hits. A little confusion up front for Hawaii, but they keep it alive. And T. Williams, it's the net. It goes over Stanford with a chance. And it drops down that time. Getting the point for Stanford is Amy Hayes. Got to tell you, Sincerova over by the net on the side, made a great acrobatic ballerina save, but to no avail, as Coach Dave Shoji calls timeout right away. KHNL Channel 13, and congratulations to the Wahines as they go to the national championships, and they're here, of course. That from Gene Kaneshiro and the Columbia Inn Top of the Boulevard staff. After the game, after the show, after anything, celebrate at Columbia Inn. Stanford serving, they're ahead 4-1 in this third game, a game they have to win. And T. Williams is stuffed up front. And Chris, if Stanford's going to get back in it, now's the time. They're doing everything right.
That's right, and I don't think that was the best set for T. Williams there out of a timeout.
5-1, that was too close to the net. T. had nowhere to go but right into the blockers. Jesse, kept alive by Stanford. Up front, dinked over. Kept alive again by Stanford. Off the rolls, off the net, and doesn't go over. It's 6-1.
Stanford is on a roll right now. Amy Hayes is having a field day up front. She's playing front row this game for Jenny Chafee. That is a lineup change that may make a difference as well.
The fickle character momentum has gone Stanford the Cardinals' way right now. That violation up front on Stanford that time. It'll be a side out for the Rainbow Wahines, a break to Hawaii. T-Triple-E back to serve for Hawaii. Looks over to Coach Shoji.